In one of our previous videos, we learned that using a micron gauge gives a more accurate vacuum reading compared to a manifold gauge. We also explained how to perform a vacuum using a manifold gauge when a micron gauge is not available. The link to that video is in the description and first comment. Now, in this video, let's learn how to perform a vacuum using a micron gauge. To perform the vacuum, we'll need vacuum pump, micron gauge with connector, core removal tool, vacuum hose, or if you don't have one, you can use a manifold gauge hose. Before vacuuming, make sure to recover all the refrigerant and confirm there are no leaks by doing a nitrogen pressure test. Now, the unit has no refrigerant and is at normal atmospheric pressure. First, remove the valve core from the service port using the extractor rod in the valve core removal tool. The valve core is similar to the pin inside a car tire valve. It allows air in and prevents it from coming out. When we remove this valve core, the air inside the system can be removed faster and easier during vacuuming. If we don't remove it, the valve core acts as a restriction, making the vacuuming process much slower. That's why we always remove the valve core. If you don't have a valve core removal tool, you can still perform a vacuum without removing the valve core, but you'll need to use a manifold gauge instead. If you would like a video about how to do a vacuum without a core removal tool, let me know in the comments. I'll upload that in the next video. After removing the valve core, connect the core removal tool to the unit. This tool will also help you reinstall the valve core later. Now, connect the micron gauge to the side port of the core removal tool. Don't connect the micron gauge directly to the vacuum pump or near vacuum pump. It will give an incorrect reading. Next, connect the vacuum hose from the unit to the vacuum pump. Start the vacuum pump and open the valve on the core removal tool. On the micron gauge, the reading will start dropping from atmospheric pressure around 800,000 microns. We should pull the vacuum until it reaches 500 to 250 microns. If you want a deep vacuum, pull it down below 250 microns. Once the target vacuum level is reached, close the valve on the core removal tool first and then turn off the pump. Now, observe the micron gauge reading for about 10 to 15 minutes. If the reading rises quickly, it means there is a leak in the system. If it rises slowly and then stabilizes, the system is just equalizing internally. If it stops rising between 500 and 1000 microns, there is still some moisture inside, so you need to vacuum again. If it stays below 500 microns, the system is tight and dry with no leaks. Now, you can remove the vacuum hose and pump. Next, reinstall the valve core. Keep the extractor rod inside the core removal tool and tighten it. Open the valve on the tool and place the valve core inside the service port and rotate the extractor rod to screw the valve core back into the service port. Once it's tight, pull the rod out slightly, close the valve and remove the rod. Then, open the valve again to check if there's any leak. If there's no leak, remove the micron gauge and removal tool and finally check at the service port for any refrigerant leak. If there is leakage, remove and tighten the valve core again. If there is no leak, you can now proceed to charge the refrigerant into the unit. There is an update. We have also started an HVAC course on Udemy. The course link is in the description and first comment, along with a 50% discount coupon code. If you're interested, join the course using that link and code. It will support our channel as well. If you found this video helpful, please like it and share it with others who might find it useful. And don't forget to subscribe to our Zebra Learnings YouTube channel. Thank you.